our good friend James Masnov.
Yeah, he's got some exciting news.
This time he'll be on the phone. Normally he visits us in the studio, but he's got a quick announcement. We'll get to that when we come back on 1430 KYKN.
And we're back with more of the Dallas Glass and Window Gator and Denise Show, presented by Len Benton Tractor.
I'm not going to tell falsehoods to the American people. I'll leave that to others.
Now, here's Gator and Denise.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the program. Glad to have you along for the ride. A conversation we've had more than once with a good friend of ours, James Masnov. It's always in studio, and it goes on not long enough.
Never it's long enough. We could do the whole entire show and maybe even add another hour or two.
But this time, he's actually calling on the phone with a quick announcement. James, welcome back to the program.
Thank you. It's great to talk to you always.
All right, so what's going on?
I just wanted to let you know and let your listeners know that I will be giving a public talk at Western Oregon University at noon this Thursday, May 17th. I believe that I have the date right. I was invited by the Social Science Department of the university to come give a public talk for an hour. It was pretty amazing. They got a hold of me and they said, come talk about history, anything you want for an hour. I was like, oh, okay.
Wow. What an honor. Yeah. That's amazing. That's great.
Yeah, I'm really looking forward to it. So there will be a lot of students and faculty there, but it is open to the public. It's free. And I'll be talking about, it's called Public Memory and the Ownership of History. It's going to be a talk in three parts. I'm going to be talking about academic history versus popular history. We're going to talk a bit about historical literacy. And then I'll finish up the final third will be about the current debates over what to do about controversial monuments. There are people who want to remove certain statues, et cetera. It goes pretty overarching, but it all has to do with this idea of who owns history.
I like it. This is literally ripped from the headlines. I mean, we've been dealing with all of this within the past couple of years. So it's very timely.
Yes, definitely. I'm really looking forward to it. There are, a lot of opinions on all sides of this. And it has to do with kind of the role of history, both inside of academia and outside. So there's a lot to talk about.
So, James, for those of us who can't get off at noon to head on over there, is this going to be live streamed or podcast or videotaped or anything?
I don't think it's going to be live stream. I'm waiting to hear back. I'm hoping it's going to be recorded, either video or at least audio, because I'd love to be able to share it with as many people as possible. I will definitely let you know.
Okay.
All right.
I hope so.
Well, I know we've gotten such great response the few times you've been on with us before. I appreciate you reaching out to us because I know a lot of people who listen, who can get off and get over there this Thursday, would love to come and see and hear this. So give us the details again about this Thursday, where you're going to be speaking over at Western Oregon University.
Yeah, so it'll be at Western at noon in the ITC building. And it'll be in room 211, which as soon as you walk in the building, there's this lecture auditorium room to the left, and that's where it is. So as long as you know it's at noon at Western in the ITC building, you'll be able to find it. And all due credit to the Social Science Department. They invited me. I feel really honored because most of the other speakers are, established professors, PhDs, and they reached out to me. So I'm very honored to be a part of this, and I'm just trying to get the word out as much as possible.
Good.
Yeah.
All right, James, I'm going to make up something that's completely not true, but you're going to go along with it just because it's going to make us all feel good about it. The Social Science Department reached out to you after listening to your several appearances on our show. We're so impressed. They wanted you to come and speak after they'd heard you on our show. Isn't that amazing?
That is amazing. It hasn't been denied, so I'll go with that.
Perfect.
Good answer.
See, that's how you do it. All right, James, thank you so much, and good luck on Thursday.
Thank you very much.
All right, James Masnov.
Congratulations to James.
Speaking this Thursday. If you
great.
Didn't get all the details and you want them, either get a hold of Denise, get a hold of me, get a hold of us through the show at the website gatoranddeniseshow.com. We have the specific information that he was just saying, so if you were driving and you're like, okay, I didn't get that written down, don't cause a wreck. Just get a hold of either one of us. It is this Thursday, May 17th at noon at Western Oregon University. It is free, open to the public, not just for the students.
Right.
So if you can.
I am so hoping that somebody records this. Listening to him speak and his writing, I mean, I read him first. He sends his papers to us that are just so fascinating and great reads. He's a very good writer. To have him be able to speak, what an honor.
So we've been talking about doing bringing Chris Ann Hall back out again.
Yeah.
She's going to come up in our conversation after this next break because we're going to get back into constitutional stuff again.
Because both of us reached out to her this weekend. Funny, huh?
Kind of works that way. And so I have this thing of bringing her back out here.
Yeah.
And then the warm-up act would be James Masnov.
Those two would hit it off.
Oh, of course.
Oh, my gosh.
Of course. But then you make it something where it's not just Chris Ann Hall.
Yeah.
And then her husband, JC, also comes along, and they do a great presentation. But, you know, we do something where it's a little bit more. We bring in this, you know, local guy. He's been on the show. And have him maybe do like his opening, maybe a 15 or 20 minute presentation on something. He coordinates it with Chris Ann so that doesn't, you know, it's not a competing thing.
Mm-hmm.
And go, hey, you know, I want to hit on this, and she's going to hit on that, and JC does his thing. I just thought, how cool that. It's a complete night. We'll just call it like a constitutional conference.
I love it.